Hi, Emma. I've got a media assignment for you. I need you to head to the small town of Eastwood where people say sculptures have been coming to life and harassing them. I know it sounds far-fetched, but take a look at the sculpture I've sent you. This could be the biggest story Fear for Sales magazine's ever done.
I trust you've received the sample I sent. One more thing. Eastwood's not exactly New York City. But don't worry. I sent along a good map. Good luck, Emma.
I've never even heard of Eastwood. I'm glad he thought to include a map. Is no good, But I think I have a program on my laptop that will help me recover it. Now, what was that password? I think I left my cheat sheet in the bedroom. just saw a girl. But now she's vanished. Prankster. I'll have to lure him out some other way.
It's past curfew. Who are you? And what's your business out here?
I'm Emma Roberts, a journalist from Fear for Sale magazine. I just want to help.
Journalists are more trouble than help, ma'am. And you better stay away from this statue. Clothes. They're turning to stone! Help! It's trying to kill me!
these aren't a typical child's drawings. They seem dark and disturbing. And whatever she draws comes true.
Thank you, Miss Roberts. Say, it looks like I could use your help after all.
When did all this start? Do you have any clues?
It all started when our city leaders decided to tear down this statue and build a playground here instead. As soon as the demolition started, the statue's look changed, evil-like. And then sculptures all over town sort of woke up. It's the darndest thing. I've got to finish my patrol. But here, This will unlock the city archive, where you can find out more.
We have breaking news. There have been reports that the renowned sculptures in the little town of Eastwood are coming alive. You heard correctly. They're coming to life. Let's see what the sheriff has to say.
We're dealing with an unexplained phenomenon that seems to have been touched off by the demolition of the statue in our town square. The plan was to build a children's playground at Eastwood Hope. Please cooperate with authorities as we investigate this matter.
We've spoken to a few residents in Eastwood who claim this has something to do with the death of the sculptor, Evelyn Rogers, who created the memorial statue. Young Amelia Jones, who served as the model for the statue, was implicated in Rogers' death. Even more fantastical, people say Jones practiced witchcraft and had the ability to make whatever she drew come true. What's going on?
I don't believe a little girl could do all that. I've got to find out the truth.
Amelia, tell her.
Emma, give me your hand. I have something to show you.
I can't. What if she sees us together?
She won't. I'll make sure of it.
I'm losing contact. You'll have to search for answers in Evelyn's house.
I need to know where Evelyn used to live. I should look in the archive. Somewhere. This must be her house. But it's down the street from where Evelyn lived.
Can I help you?
I'm Emma Roberts, a journalist investigating the strange events here in Eastwood. I have a few questions for you about Amelia Jones.
I told you journalists everything I already know.
Do you believe Amelia killed your wife?
It's hard to believe, I realize, but yes, I do. You see, Louise, she's my wife now. She saw Amelia run away from the house with Evelyn's jewels that night. When the police searched the girl's bedroom, they found the jewels. They also found a drawing she'd done of Evelyn burning in a fire.
Frank, we don't have time for this.
Look, we're in a hurry to leave. I'm sure you could talk to Sophia Jones about this. She's Amelia's mother. She lives just down the street.
Who are you?
I'm a journalist. My name is Emma.
Not this again. I'm so tired of journalists. Here's one of Amelia's drawings. Sometimes I still feel her presence. I can't leave this town, even though I hate it, because I keep thinking she's going to come home.
Tell me more about her.
She was only 10 when it happened. She'd always had such a strange gift. She could predict the future. She described what would happen by drawing it. She was just trying to warn people about the future, but instead they thought she caused bad things to happen. I'm sorry. This is bringing back bad memories for me. You'll have to excuse me, but feel free to have a look at her room if it'll help.
Thank you.
I can't believe people think Amelia would hurt Evelyn when the two were so close. But her husband, Frank? Amelia hated him. I think he's the one who killed Evelyn to get her family inheritance. But the cops won't listen to me. Frank's a well-respected pillar of the community, after all. Listen, if you want to find out what really happened here, investigate Frank. I tell you, he's hiding something. Here. Look at how Amelia drew him. She knew. My daughter knew.
You journalists sure are persistent. I told you we're leaving. I have nothing more to say.
Please, leave him alone. Don't you think he's suffered enough?
Are you accusing me of something on the basis of a kid's drawing? Evelyn was my wife. I loved her. Now leave me alone. Let me go! Please! Help!
Frank, no! Please, you've got to help. Those awful sculptures of Evelyn's dragged my husband to her half of the house. We closed it off. Too many bad memories, and that so-called art is just scary.
I'll see what I can do. Why don't you call the police? Now I need to get past this door.
Frank must die, and the townspeople here must be punished.
Evelyn, wait. I know you loved Frank. He might be innocent.
He's a traitor, and you're taking his side.
If Evelyn isn't pacified, something terrible will happen. I've got to remind her of her love for Frank.
You don't understand. Go away! I will never forgive him. He is the one to blame.
Frank's been dragged behind the house. Evelyn must have really trusted Louise. Evelyn couldn't have her own children, but having Amelia around helped make up for it.
I'll get revenge on Frank and everyone else in this town for their betrayal. They're the ones who killed me. They're the ones who killed Amelia. This is what every traitor deserves.
I don't stop Evelyn. She'll destroy this whole city. I've got to find the real culprit.
Thank you. Thank you.
Amelia's teacher showed me her awful drawings, Frank. One of them shows her killing us. Someone needs to put that girl into a mental hospital. She's a danger to herself and others.
Really, Louise? She's just a kid.
Luis is an actress too? Maybe she's not just acting on the stage. These don't match Amelia's other drawings. They look forged.
Give it to me, you little brat. No one will believe you anyway.
It was you. I know it. I hate you.
The theater is closed for the holidays. It's only open to staff at this time.
Thank you.
Luis was definitely involved in Evelyn's death and Amelia's disappearance. I just need to find evidence proving her guilt.
Thank you.
It's not an actress's usual fare, and she doesn't teach chemistry. Very suspicious.
Thank you.
It figures, on top of everything else, Louise would be the type not to return a book to the library. And here's her plan to commit the crime. She was no friend to Evelyn. Louise couldn't afford such jewelry. She kept the jewels for herself and let Amelia take the blame. I have enough evidence to accuse Louise of arson and murder. Poor Amelia. She knew the truth.
You just couldn't leave it alone. Now I have to get rid of you. You and Frank have to die now, I'm afraid. But everyone will blame the sculptors, and I'll have a solid alibi. Enjoy your last few minutes of life. I'll be back.
I can't believe it. It was Louise all along. We've got to get out of here. We need to find a way to call the police.
There's an emergency near the cliff outside town. It's about Evelyn and Amelia. Hurry!
You killed Evelyn. You can't blame Frank like you did Amelia this time, Louise.
Where's your proof? It's my word against yours.
I trusted you like a sister, and you betrayed me. Prepare to die.
Stop! If Louise turns into a statue, no one will believe us!
Wait! You've got to give Amelia justice our way, in the courts in town. Let Louise pay for her crimes.
Evelyn, please! Don't do it! You're better than this!
Amelia tried to get me to see past my own need for revenge. I didn't hear her.
I was at the police station when Frank called. What's going on? I need to know.
What's going on here?
I'm so sorry, Evelyn. I wish I'd been able to see through Louise's lies. And I'm sorry for Amelia, too.
Frank, I release you from responsibility, and I forgive the citizens of Eastwood. I trust that justice will be done. Amelia and I must rest now, in the world of spirits.
Mother, please do not wait for me any longer. You are free to go. Start a new life somewhere, and know that I am with you always.